Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. This beautiful act was gifted to Lady Fatima alayhi salam by her beloved father, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. It's a highly emphasized act of worship practiced by the Ahl al-Bayt alayhum salam. Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam is narrated to have said, reciting Tasbeeh of Lady Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam every day after every salah is liked by me more than reciting 1,000 ruk'ah of mustahab prayer. Some of us perhaps practice this tasbeeh without understanding its true significance or indeed the correct way of doing it, as it may have become a habitual practice. First, the correct order of the tasbeeh according to many established narrations is 34 times Allahu Akbar, 33 times Alhamdulillah, and 33 times Subhanallah. 2. Yet sometimes, due to haste, it's not recited properly. Some say, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, or Subhanallah, Subhanallah, Subhanallah. Or you just hear a hissing sound. The appropriate way is to stop after each dhikr. Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar. Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah, Alhamdulillah. Subhanallah, 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 and so on. It is the first thing highly recommended and established to be done as soon as we finish Salah. Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam is reported to have said, one who recites the Tasbeeh of Lady Zahra alayhi salam before even moving their feet, Allah will forgive them. Number 4, it is also very much recommended for this particular act of worship to be recited just before going to sleep as well. One who recites the Tasbeeh of Lady Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam at the time of going to bed, they will be accounted amongst those who have remembered Allah a lot, according to the narration. Some of our ulama suggest that reciting Tasbeeh of Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam at night protects against nightmares as well. Imam al-Sadiq alayhi salam is reported to have said, we teach our children Tasbeeh of Fatima as much as we teach them how to pray. Let's lead by example and inspire our children and youth not to neglect this incredibly rewarding act of the remembrance of Allah. Encourage them to recite it after each salah as well as before going to sleep. Number 6, it's actually so healing that this Tasbeeh should be recited at times of difficulty. When we're encountering a challenge in life, for example, or when we need our wishes to be fulfilled, at times of anxiety, sadness, or just to seek relief. In a narration, Imam alayhi salam states that whoever recites it, Allah will protect them from the pains of this world as well as the hereafter. Number 7, in a world of temptations and traps, we need as much help as we can. According to Imam al-Baqir alayhi salam, reciting tasbih drives away shaitan and results in the satisfaction of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In chapter 94 of the Holy Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala states, فَإِذَا فَرَغْتَ فَانْصَبْ وَإِلَىٰ رَبِّكَ فَارْغَبْ. When you are finished from salah, sit up and then turn to your Lord. One of the applications of this ayah is tasbih of Fatima alayhi salam. Imam al-Baqir alayhi salam says, Allah is not worshipped by anything more rewarding than the tasbih of Fatima al-Zahra alayhi salam. Had there been any worship superior to it, most surely the Holy Prophet would have granted it to Lady Fatima. Peace and blessings be upon them all. Number 9, it will take us a few minutes, perhaps 5 minutes at max, to recite this tasbih, but we should try to be attentive as possible. And there should be continuity in the recitation of the tasbih without any interruptions. And finally, it is recommended to use a prayer bead, and especially that made from the soil of the grave of Imam al-Husayn alayhi salam. If not, we can use our hands. If we have doubt on how many we have recited, it's best to start again. I pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He bestows upon us all the blessings of making this generous gift from Him of Tasbeeha Fatima part and parcel of our daily lives, something that we practice all the time with reflection, with contemplation, and at the same time be able to reap the fruits of it in this world and the hereafter.